Welcome to the Beyond Press Channel. Today we are going to do some vacuum experiments. And the first one is testing that can you use broken light bulb inside of the vacuum chamber. Because at least the earliest light bulbs had vacuum inside of them. I think nowadays they have nitrogen or argon gas inside of it. So it is bit question, would it work, but we are going to see. And I have electric connection on my vacuum chamber now, and for the bulb base we are going to use this Lukelamp Skontsy lamp. It is really good when you are making some stupid experiments with light bulbs. It's just the base of the lamp with the sticky bottom, so you can stick it to wherever you want. So it turned out that the glass on the light bulb is also important to protect the filament from your fingers and electric wires and everything, because they are really easy to break and we broke quite many of them. So, but now we have good lamp inside the chamber and we are going to try. So now the pump is on and air is escaping the chamber. And we are going to start with very good vacuum. And if the light bulb works, then we are going to add air until it burns out. I think we have as good vacuum as it comes with our equipment. So Anni can turn the electricity on and we are going to find out. Yeah! It works! No, now it stopped working. But it worked for a while. I think that the filament on that modern lamp was intended to use with argon or nitrogen. So with the vacuum it didn't burn with the oxygen, but I think it may be overheated or something like that, because there was no gas to transfer the heat out of the filament. But it worked like maybe 4 seconds. Yeah, here you can see the burnt bulb. And I think that there may be some kind of heat management problem, because the these parts that hold the filament are blue and they are not supposed to be blue. And next, our favorite fruit, watermelon. And I am starting to think that we are going to need some kind of watermelon sponsor. Yeah. Pump is on and now there is about 50% air left. About maybe 10 or 5. I think the water is boiling now, if there is any free water outside of the melon. Maybe 1 or 2% air left. And the melon has no signs of exploding or anything else. Now the vacuum is quite perfect and the watermelon is holding up. I think we have to drill a small hole to watermelon. And then all the gases inside of the melon should escape from that tiny hole. Let's do that. And now we have 16 mil hole on the watermelon. And now the pump is on. There is already bubbles inside of the melon. Some foam. Yeah, there is something is going on, but nothing crazy. Yeah, I think we are now at the point where the water is boiling and there is bubbles coming out of the melon pot.
Yeah, now the situation is quite stable.
Yeah, the melon is just bubbling away. And if we keep doing this, I think the watermelon is going to, I think it's not going to freeze, but somehow dry up, but that would take very long with our pump, so we are going to stop this here. And now the egg. Our egg somehow jumped, but it is still intact. Anne, can you give the readings? Point is that there is now complete vacuum and the egg isn't doing anything. So eggs are completely fine in space. Or maybe they would freeze in there, but they won't explode. There are all experiments are now done. And since we have that electric cable now in our chamber, you can suggest different electric apparatuses for our vacuum chamber. I am at least doing hair dryer quite soon and maybe some others if you want to see those. This is all for today. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.
And for today's extra content, I'm going to crush that watermelon and egg that survived. Ha ha!